Hi everyone, I'm Brian Abramowitz with the Scientist in Every Florida School program. And in this edition of Science Segments, I'm excited to connect you with a medical expert to help you learn about the human body. Who are you and what is your title?
Hello everyone, call me Giri, that's my first name. Last name is Kalamangalam. So I'm Giri Kalamangalam, I am a physician, I'm a doctor. I work here at the University of Florida. I'm an academic physician, so I teach here in the medical school and I practice medicine with our patients here.
What do you research and why is that important?
Right, I'm a neurologist. By neurologist, you mean, one means somebody who deals with the nervous system, nervous meaning brain, nerves, even the muscles. So I deal with patients who have particular kinds of neurological problems. And I research the brain functions that result in diseases of the brain that I can treat. And I also learn about the brain. While I'm doing that, I learn not just about the disease, but I also research and learn about certain aspects of the brain itself.
Can you identify the general functions of the major systems of the human body and briefly describe a few ways these systems interact to maintain homeostasis?
Right. That question really will take a few years to answer, right? But that's a beautiful question. And that tells us about how we function. And for us, you know, as we go through our lives, we might think that we are just one person and one thing. And that is true. But if you look at the details of what makes us who we are, you know, our bodies, you realize there are a lot of functioning systems. It's like having a car that's got wheels, it's got an engine, it needs gasoline, it needs seats, it needs the gear system, it needs air conditioning, it needs all these things for you to be comfortable and drive from one place to another. But all these are separate. The person who makes the wheels probably doesn't know very much about the person who makes the engine. But on the other hand, the grand designer, the folks who came up with the idea of a car, have it all worked out. So they know exactly why you need an engine here and the seat over here and the gasoline tank over there. So we're a bit like that, but much more sophisticated. So the major systems of the body, and there are many, many, and I'm not going to list them all. In fact, it's even a question as to what, in fact, is a system. But let's be very simple. The reason we can stand upright and we can walk from here to there and we don't all collapse like a lump of jelly is because we have bones. So that is a system that is a structural system, a system that's a bit like the posts in building a house or the foundation. So we need that. We need that to be rigid, right? Otherwise we'd all be like amoebae, okay? So we would be squirreling and squirming around, right? But here we are completely intact with a good shape, right? So that's if you like the bone system. Then we have something to keep everything inside and not all falling out. So we need a layer, right? We need, so that's, you could call that the, we call that the integumentary system or the skin system. And that's not just a bag in which everything that is me belongs, but it's a very, so all of these have many more functions than just the ones I'm telling you about. But we have the integumentary system. And of course, the reason I'm kind of alive and I breathe and I can talk and so on is because I use energy, and energy comes from food. And so we need a way of being able to process food so we can produce energy. And that in fact is the function of the gut. So that's an entire gastrointestinal system. That is a system. Here I am drinking a cup of tea, okay? It's got sugar in it. It's got some liquid in it, it's got some milk in it. So we drink it, and then food and drink basically create energy in our body. So that's the gastrointestinal system, that is the mouth, the gullet, the stomach, the intestines. And then not all of this is useful. Some stuff we eat, you know, not all of it can be digested, and so we need a way of expelling what we don't need. So that is the GI system. Then there is the excretory system, which is different, which is I take all of this and then it's like burning coal, for instance. Let's say you burn coal and you get this warm energy, you get the heat, right, to keep you warm. We don't use coal anymore to keep us warm, but you know, in the old days they would. So they would burn things to keep themselves warm. But then when you burn something, it gives you smoke. So you got to get rid of the smoke, right? So imagine having a fire in your house to keep yourself warm, but you don't have a way of getting rid of the smoke. What are you going to do? You can't do it. You could put the fire out immediately. Otherwise, you'll suffocate, right? So we have an excretory system. That is the system that makes urine and gets rid of all the poisons that accumulate when you burn things in your body. We have the cardiovascular system, which is the blood and the heart that circulates everything and keeps everything communicating, right? And you can just go on and on. And then you have the brain and the nervous system, which is the kind, which is the system that I have more experience with, and I treat diseases of the brain. And the brain is like the computer, right? It's what organizes a lot of what we do. It coordinates things. It makes us who we are, okay? You have a personality, right? You tell bad jokes, right? And so that, where do those bad jokes come from? They come from some process inside your head, right? But the brain is the central coordinate. It gives you a personality. It gives you coordination. It makes us see. It makes us hear. It does many, many, many things. So these are just examples. And they all have to work together, right? So you can't have a car where the one wheel goes forward and the other wheel goes backward, right? You won't go anywhere, or you'll go around in circles, whatever, right? You don't do it right. So we've got to integrate everything. And it's a miracle. It's a miracle how this happens, okay? No one really understands it. No one on earth understands it, okay? Fully. That's why we still do research. We want to find out more. So all of these systems work together to create you and me and Brian and everybody else, right? So here we are. We are eating, we're drinking, we're all interact, we're walking, we're talking, and everything communicates with everything else. And it all has to have a proper temperature. It has to have the right conditions. It's like having a plant, you know, you can't grow if it's too cold or too hot. So we have a system inside that keeps us at a constant temperature, keeps the what's called the pH, okay, which you may not know about, but how much acid, how much alkali is there in the body. There are all sorts of things that are kept in very delicate balance. There are many, many organ systems that do that. But that's what we need to stay alive and to be who we are. So that's a very simple and short answer to a very complicated question.
Well, thank you, Giri. And thank you all so much for watching. We will see you next time.
Thank you very much. Enjoy.